It's been a big Monday at the Rams facility after a dominating victory over the Indianapolis Colts in an opener with Gary Klein. I'm Lindsay Theory for the Los Angeles Times. Of course, the news still is all about Aaron Donald, who reported on Saturday but was not available to play against the Colts. Today, he went through team meetings, he went through a workout, and Coach Sean McVay said there is a possibility that he will be available to play on Sunday against the Redskins. However, Gary, he still hasn't signed that contract that the Rams put in front of him.
No contract. We'll see as this unfolds whether the fact that he's here pushes that forward. But at this point, the plan is to get him involved on some level in that game against the Washington Redskins, Sean McVay's old team. The Rams defense didn't look like it needed a lot of help in this last game. But this is going to be a much better offense with a much more experienced quarterback with Kirk Cousins.
There were a few contract extensions going around Monday. Punter Johnny Hecker, he signed an extension. Defensive lineman Ethan Westbrooks, he also signed an extension. So it's not like the Rams are afraid to pay people right now.
I think this is all part of a grand plan. The Rams are moving some money around. They're restructuring contracts, giving extensions, not only to get Aaron Donald in place, but this is also has to do with Alec Ogletree, LaMarcus Joyner, guys whose contracts are coming up. Hecker, though, was a guy that, for lack of a better term, outkicked his contract.
Very good, Gary. Very good.
He was, I think, the 11th highest paid punter before this. Now he goes to the top, a three-time Pro Bowler. Ethan Westbrooks is a guy that the Rams have played in rotation, had a couple big plays last year. He did a really good job against Indianapolis, so they want him to stay in the fold even when Aaron Donald returns.
Sean McVay celebrated his first victory as head coach when he got that Gatorade bath, and wow, Sean McVay really, he gets wild. He said he celebrated even more with his family later in the night and that he watched some Sunday night football. Now, Gary, he says he's not going to put in any extra hours this week to make sure he's prepared for the Redskins, but you've got to believe that Sean McVay would really like to show his former employer what he's up to here in Los Angeles.
There's no question. He's very close to Jay Gruden. He's close to a lot of people with the Redskins. They are the people that put him in a position to be the head coach of the Rams. But he's also got a lot of pride. He wants to show them that, you know, he can do it on his own, I'm sure. And as you mentioned, you know, there's that tendency to not do too much, you know, but he's going to dot every I and cross every T and make sure that his team is ready to perform when they play the Redskins.
Gary and I admit we were a little bit surprised by the Rams' offensive performance against the Colts. 46 points, of course, 16 of those points were because of the defense, but Jared Goff, Sammy Watkins, Robert Woods, Cooper Kupp, and even Todd Gurley, they're making some catches out of the backfield. The offense was starting to look like a well-oiled machine.
It looked closer to the version we saw in the preseason against the Oakland Raiders, right? When everyone was pretty encouraged by what they saw, and then the Chargers, it seemed to take a step backward. Lots of weapons out there. All of the people, as you mentioned, that they picked up as free agents and trades in the draft, it was all out there, and it was on display. And I'm sure there's more that we didn't see that they held back for maybe this week against Washington. But it was the Indianapolis Colts. Yeah. It wasn't a very good defense. But the fact is, if you're a Rams fan, you should be encouraged.
And it was the Indianapolis Colts backup quarterback, Scott Tolzien, who the Rams were able to get 16 points off of. Trumaine Johnson, LaMarcus Joyner, both had pick sixes. And then Corey Littleton with a safety there at toward the end of the game. This is exactly what Wade Phillips' defense was designed to do. It's designed to put defensive backs in position to make plays. And already they're having a big impact.
LaMarcus Joyner, his first career interception, he takes it back for a pick six. Trumaine Johnson, we've talked about, a guy that didn't get the long-term deal he was seeking, but seems to have kind of put that behind him, or at least is using it as motivation, has turned into a real team leader, and he also gets a pick six. So if you're Wade Phillips, that you saw that performance without Aaron Donald. Now you're going to add him to the mix. Again, Indianapolis Colts, who knows what they're going to do the rest of the season, but an encouraging performance by the defense.
Okay, and finally, the big topic for a lot of folks in Los Angeles today was the fan turnout at the Coliseum, or perhaps the lack of fan turnout at the Coliseum. This wasn't that unexpected. This team is coming off a 4-12 season. Los Angeles, it's accustomed to supporting a winning franchise, not necessarily in football, what I'm talking about, but whether you're the Lakers or the Dodgers, if you win, fans come out. What do you expect this next week?
I think it'll be a much better turnout. I don't know that – I haven't checked the weather yet, but it's probably not going
to
be quite –
I did. It's supposed to be a little bit cooler. We were sweating it out there Sunday.
So I don't think it's going to be quite as hot. the Rams have something on their resume, for lack of a better term. They've shown that they can score points, and people are going to want to come out and see that, I think. I don't know that the Coliseum is going to be, overflowing, but I think it will be a much better turnout. And the fact is, the Washington Redskins have a little bit of a national following as well, so I would expect to see a lot of their fans there too.
The Rams have a full week of practice. Keep it on the Los Angeles Times. Gary and I will be here chronicling every step of the way. All right, with Gary, I'm Lindsay. We'll see you later this week from the Rams facility.